The story made headlines around the world. 12 boys and their soccer coach trapped inside a cave in Thailand for more than 2 weeks, successfully rescued.
Now, one of the people who helped with the rescue efforts is from Marion, Illinois. Tanet Natisri volunteers in Thailand to help with water management. And he joins us now to talk about his experience in helping with the rescue. And thanks so much for being here. This got so much attention. I'm sure you have a lot of thoughts on this.
Yeah, sure.
Why were you over there in the first place? You were there before this ever happened, right?
Yes, actually, I already there working with the government with the water project around Thailand, you know. And then I think it was around almost a month and a half. And then the military gave me a call and see if I can go in and, you know, help out with the rescue.
Talk about kind of what your thoughts were when you got that call, found out that these boys were rescued. I mean, how hard is it to set the system up and that sort of thing? What were your first thoughts?
I thought it's going to be a really simple task. You know, at the beginning, it's just a really small operation. I think it's going to be just walk in the park. But when I got there, I mean, I kind of realized that the situation is really serious. And it's much more complex than I thought.
What did we not understand about that story? Because we would talk about it all the time. We'd say, why didn't the kids just run out the front? And we never got a good explanation. What have you heard over there?
Well, here's the thing. The cave system itself is about 10 kilometers long. And the mountain range where you have the cave is about 2,000 acres. And then you have, you know, the catchment area. Every time when it rains, you're talking about 10,000 acres of the catchment area that water can go inside the cave. So it's almost nearly impossible to stop water from getting into the cave. So it's, if you try to drain out all the water in the cave, I mean, that's not the option.
So it's just not even an option. So tell us about your system then. So you brought in kind of a pipe system with pumps. Talk about that. How hard was it to install and what was the purpose? What did it actually do?
We do about three operations in my responsibility. So we drain out the water from around the mountains and inside the cave. And then we also stop water from going in to the cave itself. So you stop water from going in and then you drain the water out. But even then, it's still, you know, a lot of water that running inside the cave. I mean, we just able to keep the water level down to where we could do start the operation, but in terms of try to dry the cave, I mean, that's not, like I say, that's not the options.
The one thing that we heard time and time again here in the United States was this is not going to end well. A lot of people didn't think that the boys were going to make it out. What were people on the scene saying? Were they optimistic? Were they starting to think, wow, we're out of options?
Well, tell you the truth, in the beginning, you know, when we decided to start a dive operation, we were thinking at 70% chance of success. Mm-hmm. So some of the kids might not go out alive, but thankfully, you know, all of them are safe.
Talk about the timing of this. So you got the call, you went in, you had to set up this system of pipes to try to get that water out. How long did it take you to get that set up?
It took 2 days to get the draining operation set up. We got thousands of people that work on the scene, mm-hmm. Thousands of soldiers, and that's not included volunteer. So probably you're looking at 5,000-6,000 of people.
Were you there when the boys started coming
That's
out?
That's what I was just going to ask, yeah.
Yes, you get to I was there.
What was that like when they finally came out?
It's just big relief for all of us, you know, just being so happy that finally, I mean, they're out. I mean, we were working so hard, like, you know, not just us, but people from around the world. We all come together, and to see the boy came out of the cave and be alive, all of them, that's just a miracle.
It is a miracle.
Thankfully, yes.
Yeah, it's amazing, and just such a true miracle. Now, have you seen any of the boys since then?
I actually have a friend over there. They have this procedure where nobody could talk to the boy for 7 days after the rescue. But I have a friend there that who sent me pictures and, you know, keep me updated on the condition of the boys and how they are. And but as you know, they're really strong, healthy, and happy.
That's great. And I think everybody has had questions about the coach.
There's so many.
Yeah,
right.
Can you give us any information on the coach and kind of what, you know, what his mindset was, how he got out, and how people reacted to him taking the kids in there?
I mean, some people actually blame him for it. Mm-hmm. You know, it's his responsibility. And I think it's something to do with he didn't ask for permission to go inside the cave at the beginning with. But again, it's raining season. You know, you're not supposed to bring the kid inside the cave anyway.
Right.
But since he did, and I think, you know, people kind of forgive him.
Sure. Yeah.
Now you're in Marion, Illinois now. How did you end up in Marion, and what do you do in Marion?
Actually running a restaurant, Thai restaurant, called Tidy Restaurant in Marion with my wife. That's it.
All right. Well, thanks so much for making the trip over here today. Very nice to meet you and sharing your story today.
All right. Thank you so much.
We really appreciate your time. Thank you.
All right. Well,